sure, you know, whatever happens, I know I'm going to sit down with Lou, regardless of what we, you know, what the outcome comes. And so, you know, him and I have had a great relationship, and I said, so I know we'll sit down and we'll see what happens.
Are you surprised at your offensive output during the
playoffs? Like you said, I think, I wouldn't say surprised. I think everyone wants to contribute and everyone expects themselves to contribute. So, you know, being able to achieve it, it might be, you know, were you surprised that you were able to, you know, achieve, you know, goals, something like that. And so I think it was, like I said, it was just a, it was a great experience. And, you know, I don't think I'm going to be a 60 plus point man next season or by any means.
Don't be saying that now. Well, you mean?
Well, I'm setting the bar lower. I'm going to say I'm going to be at least 80. Like I said, I think, like I said, it's just one of those things where, you know, I've said it a lot. I just benefited from the way the team was playing as a whole, and like I said, I you know, the points were a nice addition, but I think the reality was, you know, my goal was to be the leader back there on the defense and try to help pull the, you know, the defensive core and be a leader and do what I can to help the. You know, help the team be successful. So I really felt that going into the playoffs that, you know, I would have to be a big part of, you know, the defensive core if we were going to have success. And it worked out well in terms of, you know, the success that the defense had. But like I said, but by no means was it just me. So that's why we were calling ourselves a no-name D. And that's why we put all the numbers on the bottle. And because, like I said, it's a... like I said, there's no way I would have had that success with everybody else. If you look on paper, a lot of people wouldn't say we had a chance, but so we didn't look at the, you know, look on paper. You just come in and everyone, you got to have that mindset that you have the team to go there, and that throughout the season you're going to learn about your team, and as the season goes on, and if there's some things that need to be done at the trade deadline and stuff like that, that's you hope that your team's, you know, at least shown what it needs and what it needs to make a run. And the acquisition of Zimmerman was a great timing, and it really helped balance us out. And then just as you keep going on and you sort of have more and more success in the playoffs, and you really, you know, you start believing even more. And I shouldn't say even believing, just you start seeing that you're getting closer to realizing which was one of your goals at the start of the season. I think everyone comes in at the start of the season, you know, wanting to win.
What was it like coming back yesterday with the fans waiting outside for you guys?
That was a really nice surprise. I think it was heartwarming to see that, because we weren't expecting that. It was raining, you know, and I don't know how long they've been out there, because, you know, charter flights can get delayed, and we don't, you know, so for them to be out there standing and, you know, it was nice. And like I said, the fans were unbelievable in the playoffs. It was the loudest I've ever heard this building. We weren't able to get the Stanley Cup, but I think our fans are happy we beat the Rangers. So if there's anything we gave them, you know, it was that. I think we would like the Stanley Cup as well, but hope they'll be happy with that for now, until we're able to bring the cup home.